Hello guys, welcome to Expose GH. If today is your first time of tuning into our channel, you know what to do. Subscribe and don't forget to turn on your notification button so that anytime we post a video, you'll be the first person to get it. So we all know that marriage counselors are taking all over Accra here. Yes, marriage counselors are tough. I mean, there are a lot of them. We all see them on the TV, radio, they are giving advices to my couples, incoming marriage couples, advice. So when our Captain Smart today, in the FM program, see if they suspend us, they'll go to a different church. He was referring to the Pentecost church, okay? He said there's this nun in Pentecost that said, worry about. Maybe I'll say, they'll ask you that particular question, and he will say it's a stupid question that the pastor will ask a man, say, we are bear man. So when you're bear man, then a pastor and the pastor say, on your bear man. So he said questions like that shouldn't be asked. But when he said Pentecost, yeah, that is the unknown, that is what they always do. Say, oh, we are bear man, or be warrior, or bow, or church. Now, that is the first question they'll ask you. Are you a man? Also, Dabi, or you boy, or bound, you have a man. So, he said some of these questions are some of the questions that they shouldn't even ask anybody. That can you impregnate her? So, I want me to come back as a worry. Yes, and he also said that we should not listen to those fake marriage counselors that will come and sit on the TV stations and be advising people to stay in their relationships, because at the end of the day, you are the one suffering that relationship. You are the one going through all the problems. You know, to say, oh, maybe it's not in the stations. No, I can say you should stick there, because God said nothing should come in between the two of you. So you just stay inside that marriage and be suffering. He said it is the stupidities of the highest degree for you to stay in a relationship or a marriage that is not helping you. You are not growing in it. You are not degreeing, and then a counselor is telling you, say, stay there. Because God said don't untie the marriage, so you should be there like that. So he said we shouldn't listen to those fake. Yes, he said they are fake counselors. And when you watch TV stations, not only TV stations, when you listen to radio stations, we've seen or heard a lot of marriage counselors speak a lot about marriages, relationships. They even end up saying a lot of things about women. If you want to be in a relationship, you have to be submissive, you have to be this, you have to be that. Yes, we've seen a lot, we've heard a lot of them, and I'm sure you have also watched them on TV before, or you've heard them on the radio talking about marriages and the problem that people face. And I also agree with Captain Smart on this particular issue, because when you are in a relationship, okay, and you are going through trauma, you are not being happy in that particular relationship, and you are still in the relationship because you have kids, for example. Yes, you have kids aside, so you'll be saying that, oh, Kwalani Tiao, Nyasadi, and Kameko, and Nyasadi, and Kameko, da da da. So at the end of the day, Kwalani Tiao, you will die and leave the kids. So, some Kwalani Tiao, some Kwalani Tiao, the dear, you do food, who can't want to see me, then they also, oh, they talk for more, who talk for. So most mothers, that is what they always say in their marriages, because of the child, because of the children, because of what people will say. So you stay in that marriage, say, God said don't untie the marriage. So you die. Then that person will go and be married. Whether it's from the man, from the woman, no one should be in a marriage that you will not have peace of mind in it. So you shouldn't be in that particular marriage. So you shouldn't be in that particular marriage because you had a counselor on TV saying that no marriage is perfect. So whatever that you are going through, you have to stick to it. It's a big no to that. If you are not happy, leave it and go. Even Reverend Obafor said it. Also that so partner is disturbing you, leave that person alone. Also that there are plenty beautiful women. So if your wife is disturbing you, leave her alone. Go and find another wife. If your husband is disturbing you, leave him. Go and find another husband. You shouldn't stay in marriages that you are not happy in, and that you are always pretending that you are happy, which is really bad. Your mental health. At the end of the day, you go to a psychiatric hospital because you are risking your mental health in the name of what people will say if you leave that particular marriage. Let them say. At the end thank you so much for tuning in. That is what I have to say today. So guys, whoever that you know that is in a marriage that is not helping he or she, please advise them, okay? Advise them to leave that particular marriage, because at the end of the day, you matter. And you left the marriage. And so what? You are the one going through that particular pain. So why should you listen to what somebody would say? Like I already said, your happiness matters. You come first before what anybody will say. Your family, forget about them. You matter.